Hey everybody! Just getting ready to do the live here for the art journaling. Give me just a second so I can get everything all pulled up and ready to go. Okay, took me just a second to get everything going. The live notification was a bit slow there. Hi Luba, hi Linda. It's good to see you guys. Oops, I need to get my camera focused here. Tonight is splatter, so I'm super excited about that because I love to make a mess. I pre-pull the okay, let me get my thoughts straight here. Welcome to Art Journaling with the Painted Cicada. My name is Tara Lynn. I am going to create with you tonight. And what I like to do is use my art journal here. You do not have to use a journal. You can create on paper, on canvas, whatever you like. But I like to create in an art journal. So I'll just flip here slowly so you can just see some of the previous art journaling sessions we've had. Sometimes they are successful and sometimes they are a learning experience, and that's okay because they're just opportunities to create and to play with art supplies. So when I do art journaling, what I like to do, hi Kevin, what I like to do is I have this ring of prompts here. And I randomly pull them. For anybody who signs up for the event, who registers, you get an email with the prompts beforehand. So the prompts I picked today are sketch, use purple, scribble, mandala, add hearts, and add pretty paper. I'm going to go ahead and put these up. Whenever I use these little small slips, I end up losing them. So I wrote them on a little post-it so that everybody can see them and I don't shuffle them off my table. Before I start, I'll just show you kind of what I gathered. I don't go crazy, but I like to have some supplies kind of at my disposal here, whether or not I use them. So I always have a stash of acrylic paint by my desk here. So that is my primary art supply. I knew that I was going, or after I pulled mandala, I knew I was gonna need something with those. So I grabbed a stencil with one on it, and these are some Jane Davenport stamps of mandalas that I could maybe use. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. We'll have to see where it goes. One of the prompts was sketch, so I've got a charcoal pencil and a Stabilo All pencil. Stabilo All pencils are my absolute favorite. And then I have a little blender thing. I've got some ink. I've got some Mod Podge. One of my prompts I pulled was add pretty paper, so I've got an old piece of scrapbook paper here, and then this was just a little clipping from an envelope I got from one of my artist trading card buddies. And then I've got a stencil here with some words on it. So not sure what I'm gonna use, but we'll see, we'll feel it out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get started with the add pretty paper. I want that to kind of be in my background here. So take a minute and go grab some scrap paper, something pretty, just an old clipping, anything you want. And I'm gonna start by gluing this on. You can either, if you're participating with me, hi Vicky. If you're participating with me, you can work step by step with me doing the same things that I do, or you can work with your own creativity, and I just encourage you to use the prompts. You can use them in any order or in any way that you interpret them. So yay, we've got lots of people on tonight. Luba and Linda, my husband Kevin popped on. Making fun of my name, Hawaiian Locust. Thank you. Hi, Julie. Hi, Vicky. If there's anybody I missed, go ahead and say hi in the comments. I'm going to start by just tearing this paper. I'm not going to use scissors. I like the rough edges. Two of you watching tonight, I know from swapping artist trading cards, so you might recognize this little piece of envelope that I'm sure I got from Mary, but anytime I get a little pretty piece of art, I save it, no matter where it comes from. So I'm just going to start by gluing some of these pretty papers onto my background here. The scrapbook paper I picked is really thick, so I'm not sure how it's going to translate on here. I'm just going to go Mod Podge crazy and see what happens. Really thick, almost like vintage wallpaper, which is cool for creating with, but not the best for Mod Podging or decoupaging. Thank you. sometimes I do use glue, like just straight glue underneath. I have tacky glue. I don't usually keep the tacky glue at my desk. I do have white glue on my desk. Sometimes I use that for underneath, which I guess is the same. Similar as tacky glue. That would probably work a lot better. Let's see. If you guys will give me just a second, I'm going to let this dry. And I was supposed to post a link for this somewhere, and I absolutely forgot. And I'm trying to get better about that. So, give me just a second while this dries, and I'm going to do that. Got to get better about remembering everywhere I need to post this, or I will never grow. Okay. Now, that was two folds, so I got that posted and it's dried a little. It's still kind of wet because I used a lot of that Mod Podge, but that's okay. So that was my Add Pretty Paper, and I'm not gonna go too crazy with it, like I said earlier, because it's just adding a little dimension on my background. I am gonna hit this real quick with my hair dryer, so I am going to turn the mic off for just a second, and then I'm going to use my pencils and sketch over the top. Okay, that just makes it so that the pencil will work smoothly. If the Mod Podge is still wet, it doesn't work the best. Okay, for my sketch prompt, I think, I'm not very good at sketching. But I think what I want to do is maybe kind of make a city line or a skyline. So I'm going to pick vanishing point here. Not the best at perspective, but let's see what I come up with. Okay, so I'm just gonna sketch maybe like a city. So I'm gonna have taller buildings up front here, and they would get smaller as they move towards this vanishing point back here. I'm just going to sketch right over whatever paper I have. I And I'm using, this is just a pit charcoal pencil. Charcoal is kind of fun because it blends and smudges. So I'm just gonna add some buildings. I'm gonna get my regular pencil out and also add some graphite in there. Smudge this into some building shapes, even more. One of these paper smudgers. I don't really use it very often, but it'll save your fingers and some of the heavy lifting. Alright, now that I've got that, oof. That's my sketch. I'm gonna just kind of refine my sketch a little bit. So, maybe I have a sidewalk here. And then, like, this would be my road. Then I'm gonna go ahead and use this Stabilo All pencil, which if you ever do art lessons with me, I'm telling you, this is my favorite thing in the whole wide world. So I'm just gonna add some details to these buildings in the front, because the closer they are, the more detailed you would see. Might be in Cincinnati, so we have a building with a crown on it. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that in there. These buildings here in the front have more shape to them, so you're gonna be able to see the lines a lot better. But I still want it to be sketchy, so. Adding a little detail on the back. it. If anybody else is sketching, what are you sketching? Did you choose to go with the city, or are you working on something else? I need to sharpen this, so bear with me if it gets noisy. Music note paper. That sounds really pretty. I'll be excited to see how that turns out, Linda. Now the theme tonight is splatter. I think I'm gonna splatter maybe somewhere in the middle and then somewhere at the end. So the prompts tonight, if you're just joining in, are add hearts, mandala, scribble, use purple, sketch, and add pretty paper. Now, I've done the two. I've done the add pretty paper and the sketch. You guys can work in whatever order you would like. Ooh, cherry blossoms! That sounds so pretty. I love cherry blossoms. Luba, I saw one of your events coming up that had, like, I think it was a door hanger with some cherry blossoms. That was really pretty. I was considering doing that. Ooh, a face would be really cool. I'm really bad at faces, but I keep trying to practice, hoping one day I'll get better at those. Alright, so I'm gonna do the scribble prompt next. Oh, Julie, I am on the west side. I'm in Harrison. If I remember correctly, I think you're in Harrison also. Or on the west side, at least. I feel like we touched base at some point, and then COVID got crazy. Let me see. I need to find something to scribble with. I think I might just go scribbly with some Sharpies. I don't use alcohol ink very often. All right, so now I'm doing the scribble. I'm just using the word Cincinnati, Ohio, but I'm kind of scribble writing, so it's not real legible. I'm just kind of doing this wherever I feel like I need some color. My scribble. That's easy peasy. Okay. I think now I am going to... Oh, Bridgetown. That's so close. I used to live in Bridgetown. I went to Bridgetown Junior High when I was younger. Many, 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 many years ago. I'm going to do my first set of splatters using purple, which is one of my prompts here. So, see, I'm going to do like a violet purple and then more of a indigo purple. Dioxazine purple. I think for my first set of splatters, I want to go kind of big with it. So I've got these little pipette droppers. No, a lot of people probably don't have those, but I'm just going to mix water in this way. This was a random art supply I got from a thrift store. Julie, these are really fun to do with kids. Kids love when you pick prompts randomly, so, I don't have a lot of kids that join on my art journaling, but I think kids would love this. The way I'm going to do my splatters is just to kind of suck up some of this paint here. And I'm just dropping it on. There's a lot of different ways to splatter, but... This is kind of fun. I don't get to just throw paint around like this very often. so that's my first use of the splatter for the night. And I used purple, so I can cross that off my list. Once again, I'm going to turn off my mic for just a minute, and I'm going to use my blow dryer to dry this off so I can layer on top of it. The splatter is going to take forever to dry. Some of it's cooling, so I'm just gonna move it around a little bit. That'll get me some more splatters and maybe help it dry a little bit. Next time I do splatters, I think I'm going to throw some paint around off my paintbrush, which is what I originally envisioned. took longer than I thought to dry. It's still kind of wet in a lot of places, but that's okay. I'm just gonna keep on working through my prompts here. This is watercolor paper, so it's really absorbent, so I'm not sure why it was taking so long, but sometimes that's how it just works, I guess. I think I'm going to add my mandalas now. I'm going to do, I think I'm just going to do one large mandala in black up here at the top. And I'm just going to use acrylic paint and this stencil here. Paper is a little warped, so I'm not sure how it'll turn out, but we shall see. Whatever paint I used smells so funny. It smells like the inside of a pumpkin. Like when you carve a pumpkin. I don't know if that means my paint's going bad or if it's just a funny smelling. Alright. So I've got that one up there. I might add just another half of it down here just to keep the flow, keep my work balance. Alright, so I am zipping through my prompts, but I still feel like I've got a lot of work to do before I feel like this will be finished. So, I did add pretty paper, sketch, use purple, scribble, and mandala. And the last prompt I have is add heart. So, I might wait a little bit and kind of do that towards the end. But I definitely feel like I need to add some layers to this. So, I think I'm going to just pull out some more paint and go with my theme and splatter a bit. I'm going to try to use some of the colors here on this paper that I pulled out. So, maybe a bright blue would go well with my purples, and there's some green in there. Ugh, I want some of this Grinchy green. There it is, citron green. I bought a bunch of this when I did a Grinch lesson back around Christmas time, and it's like one of my favorite greens. Shoo, I think I'm gonna do some more splatters. And first thing I'm gonna do is just kinda, I think I'm just gonna add some splotches of this first. And some of these empty areas. blobs of color, and then I'm gonna come back and splatter it. So this time I'm just gonna add a little bit of water, and I'm gonna get my paintbrush really, really wet. Now I don't wanna thin it out too much because I want my splatters to be pretty opaque, and I'm just gonna splatter this on. I really should have an apron on, but I don't really have much else but paint clothes, so I don't know that it matters, I guess. Oh, the Ferris wheel! I love it. We have a sky wheel downtown, and I've never been on it. With me tonight, I can tell you right now that my journal is going to take me forever to dry because there's so much paint on here. I'm definitely going to have to leave this baby open tonight. Alright, so there was my green. And now I'm going to do the same thing with this bright blue. Again, I'm just going to add some in, blend it around. First, I get much better splatters the higher up I splatter, so I'm going to try to just kind of hold this up and some pretty big splats. In order to get some smaller ones, I've got this brush nice and wet, and I'm just gonna tap, and that'll make some finer splats. This is so messy. I love it. Back, and I think I'm going to make some of those tap splats with the green here. button. Oh my gosh, this is so much fun. I'm making a giant mess. I don't know if you guys use baby wipes when you paint, but I have baby wipes all the time. I really like how those splatters have turned out. I think I'm going to add a little more purple splatter, just because add purple was one of my prompts, so I want to be pretty heavy with it. Hey, Serena! Thanks for hopping on! Oh my gosh, okay. I feel like this is never gonna dry. And my vision, is to I'm kind of at a thinking point. Okay. I like where it's going. What I'd like to do, I think, is stamp, like use my stamp mandalas, because that was one of my prompts, so I want to, you know, add some more of those, but I'm not going to be able to stamp until some of this is dry. So I want to add a layer of stamps on top, and then I want to add some hearts, some scribble hearts at the end, but again, my paint needs to be dry. So while you guys are working, I think I'm just gonna mute myself and I'm gonna try to dry some of this and see if I can't do some of it on camera in maybe 5 minutes or so. I'm so glad you joined tonight, Vicky. Hopefully I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, I dried as much as I have the patience to dry right now. I can tell you that it's not gonna dry completely tonight. I actually feel like I've got some elevation like in some of these spots, so I'm not gonna be able to do everything I wanna do with it this evening, but I will definitely work on it just a little bit more before I end, and then I will post my completed lesson on the Painted Cicada Facebook page. But if you have been working with me tonight, I really want to see how yours turns out. I know I'm so interested to see how the face sketch works and how the music notes turn out, and you know, the different colors that you guys are using. I think Luba was making cherry blossoms, so all of these are going to end up so different, and I cannot wait to see them when you guys finish. Make sure you tag me in those. washi tape that I've had stuck to my desk for probably 2 weeks now, and I think I'm gonna try to use it on this lesson. Because why not? It's been sticking here forever, just waiting for a home. I wish I would have thought of it earlier, because it would have been cool to have some of this underneath. Hey, Angel! I am so glad you hopped on! I'm over here making a mess. It's always nice when friends pop on. I'm not going to be able to do too much more tonight because my splatters were so splattery that I have to wait for them to dry a bit. I had a stamp. Somehow I lost it. Used it. I put it back. Thought I put it back. And then it runned away. I'm not sure how that happens, but I don't know. I guess I've got a ghost here in my craft space stealing my stuff. The big black flowers were a stencil. They were just a big stencil that I used. So you wouldn't believe where this started. So my prompts tonight were add pretty paper. So I just added some scrapbook paper, sketch. I sketched a city in the background. Used purple, so then I splattered purple and kind of a pink purple on the city there, because tonight's theme was splatter. And then mandala was one of my prompts, so I thought this was kind of mandala-y, so I did these two big flowers, and then I splattered some more with some more colors. And I used a whole lot of paint. So, like, some of these splatters won't be dry till tomorrow, I can tell. So it's kind of prohibited me from doing as much as I wanted. And that's kind of where I am. And then the last prompt I'm probably going to have to do tomorrow after this dries was add hearts. So Thank you. Sometimes they work out and sometimes they don't, but it's fun to play. No matter what, you know? Just to get my supplies out and do something I haven't tried before. Definitely don't work in this style a lot, and so I had a lot of fun tonight with this one. I'm so annoyed. I lost my little mandala stamp. I'm gonna fixate on that until I find it, probably. But I think that's all I have for tonight. I'm going to have to finish the rest after it dries, but I will definitely post my work on the Painted Cicada, and I hope you guys post your work as well. I do have another art journaling lesson coming up if you're interested. The next one is February 11th, and it is hearts is the theme. I also have another class coming up this Friday. It is a paid class, but it's super fun. It's called Mother Willow. It's only $10, so if you love making art, feel free to join me in my class on Friday. I would love to see you. Can't wait to see what you guys created, and thank you all for hopping on with me tonight. Have a good night, everybody.